Welcome to this detailed look at infusion cloning. Developed by Takara Biosciences, infusion cloning is closely related to ligation-independent cloning. These techniques are sequence-independent and result in seamless cloning products. Infusion cloning allows you to add any insert into any vector at any site, making it an extremely versatile cloning method. There are three main steps in performing your infusion cloning experiment: linearizing your vector, PCR amplification of inserts, and performing the infusion reaction. The first step in infusion cloning is to linearize your vector at the insertion site. The infusion reaction works with any vector suitable for downstream experimental use. The two main methods of vector linearization are restriction enzyme digestion and inverse PCR. Vectors may be linearized using restriction enzyme digestion, with either one or two enzymes selected to cut at the insertion point. Inverse PCR has become a common way to generate a plasmid backbone for cloning. Select primers that will amplify along the length of your chosen cloning vector, incorporating required functional elements for plasmid growth and replication. Your fragment of interest will fill the gap between the primers after successful infusion cloning. Single insert infusion cloning requires a PCR product that spans the insert of interest and adds the necessary nucleotides for annealing to the vector. Researchers achieve this by designing primers containing a template-specific portion and a vector-specific tail. To do this, design your primers with the template-specific sequences at the 3' end facing into your target. Then add a 5' tail that will overlap with your linearized cloning vector. The overlapping tail for single insert infusion cloning is typically 15 nucleotides. The resulting PCR fragment will be your fragment of interest with short regions of homology that match your linearized cloning vector. Multi-insert cloning works similarly, except that the overlaps must also match between adjacent insert fragments as well as the vector. When attempting to clone multiple inserts, overlaps should be 20 base pairs long. In SnapGene, the infusion cloning tool will automatically design primers that generate the correct size overlaps for your experiment. After amplification and cleanup, combine your purified fragments with the infusion reagent. Incubate your fragments with the infusion reagent for 15 minutes at 50 degrees Celsius. The infusion reagent will chew back the nucleotides from the 3' ends of the linearized DNA, allowing the complementary overlaps to anneal. You then transform the mixture into E. coli, where E. coli's DNA repair machinery will create an intact plasmid. To learn more about molecular cloning, visit snapgene.com.